Hey guys, it's Charlie G. Today I'm going to be going over salaries. How much should you be worth? It's one of the big questions that you should ask if you are either starting a new job or even leaving college and you don't know where you should start off at. Well, let me tell you this. Do not let the typical steps by steps lead you into where you should be worth. Like for me in the design field, they have junior designers, mid-level designers, and senior designers. I didn't let that pretty much factor in how much should I be worth. It's what I bring to the table, and you don't have to go through these levels each step of the way. You could be a junior and just jump straight to being a senior level designer. That's completely normal. Or you may even just be getting out of college, but because you're that good, you've been putting so much time and effort into what you do, you're already a senior level designer. It's all about the experience and how much knowledge you have and your skill set as well. Your skill set may be far and superior. You may be a genius in your field. So do not let these things go determining by step how much you should be worth. You could be a huge jump. I remember one recruiter I spoke to, I told her how much I was getting on my previous place and how much I'm getting my current place. And she was like, oh, this is a huge jump. You know, typically it's usually a $10,000, $20,000. Well, good for you if you have that mindset. I don't, you know, if I'm gifted at something, I'm going to pursue it, and how much I'm worth is how much I'm worth. Do not try to tell me that I need to go from $90,000 to $100,000, then $110,000. No, I can go from $100,000 to $150,000 to $200,000 to $300,000 because that's how much I'm worth, how much I'm bringing to the table. So don't be fooled by these recruiters or anyone is trying to enforce you that you have to follow a certain series in order for you to be worth a certain value. You could jump, you could make huge leaps because you are gifted. That is who you are. You're just a natural talent. Just remember to always let that stick in terms of determining how much you should actually be worth. I remember my first job straight out of college. I was making around the 80s and I had some other things going on. Pretty much I was bringing in six figures in total with everything I had going on. And at the time I was freelancing, doing some websites for some people, and I was charging them like $30 an hour. I was definitely undercharging them, but some of these were relationships with small businesses and friends of mine that I pretty much knew. So I was not trying to break their bank. And it also helped me gain some experience as well. It was fine. But in terms of determining your hourly rate, if you're, for example, on a salary and determining your hourly rate, these are some maths that you can use. It's not precise. I'm just giving a suggestion. You could be around there, you could be below or even higher than that. So let's use the 80K scenario. I usually take 0.00065 times that whole salary in terms of determining how much should I be worth on a W-2 basis. So that translates to about $52 an hour. That means pretty much I should have been charging that much. It could have been 50, it could have been 45, it could have even been 55. Again, this is a range. It's not really a set math in terms of how much you should definitely been charging. You have to evaluate yourself and figure out exactly where you fall in that range. And the reason the hourly rate on a W-2 is not set precise, like you don't just do like 80,000 divided by 52 weeks and then divided by 40 weeks, is because you have vacation times on a salary basis. You have sick times, you have all these things. On a W-2, you don't have that privilege. So you have to factor all that in. So you have to overcharge to compensate for that factor. On a 1099, because you do have to pay a bit of extra in taxes, since your employer is yourself, you don't have an employer distributing to certain taxes, then you actually are paying double in certain tax areas. So you have to charge actually a little bit more. And the rule of thumb that I try to suggest is 0.00075. So for the 80,000, that's actually $60 an hour. So I would be charging a little bit more. As we can see, for salary, I'll be at 80,000. For an hourly, I'll be at $52 an hour. And on a 1099, I'll be at $60 an hour because I do have to pay my own taxes. So these are some of suggested ranges, but you don't have to follow that precisely. It just gives you like a mark where you can have like a bit of a starting point. I remember another design gig I had with a company. It was a contract basis. And then after some time of being there, they wanted to switch me over. Now, I already felt I was good at what I do. I've had the experience, I had the knowledge and the skill set as well. So I knew how much I wanted and how much I was worth. So they came back to me with an offer. I turned it down 3 times until I eventually accepted it. And the way that they kind of maxed it out too is they offered some form of equity. So that could be assets, stocks. And what they had was actually stocks. You have to consider these things as much more valuable. So let's say someone was willing to offer you $10,000 extra in salary versus offering you $10,000 in stocks. The $10,000 in stocks is worth a lot more because it grows. It doesn't just stay stagnant. You get taxed on your salary. If you're being paid $10,000 extra, you're probably only going to be seeing maybe half of that or even less. You know, it's not really worth it. But in terms of the stocks, because it grows, you're not. You actually have that whole amount of money until you actually withdraw. Then you have to worry about paying taxes on that portion. And since you're doing this at a later time, you can actually control a bit of how you get taxed. I know some companies automatically take the tax for the stocks right away, but it really doesn't matter because it grows, you know? Like my company, at that time, they gave me about $10,000 worth of stocks, but after taxes, the stock today is worth $12,000 after taxes, meaning after I give Uncle Sam, I'm actually up 20% on what the original amount was. It pretty much doubled. You know, you have to consider these things and factor these things in place. So don't just sleep on assets and stocks and equity. Like always take a bigger equity and lesser of a salary if you can, because it does benefit you in the long run. My current job, at the time I'm actually recording this video, I didn't have to do any negotiations. Right off the gate, they gave me what I wanted, plus the equity and all these different incentives. It was terrific, it was great. I can't say I did it all alone. I have to thank God for it all because he opened up the door that I wasn't really looking for. It just really came out of nowhere, but it's just God doing his thing. You have to really learn to trust whatever higher power that you believe in. I know many of us don't have the same beliefs, but for me, it's God. So whatever higher power you believe in, just entrust your faith, hold on and lean to the process. Just continue to be a good person. Give back good energy to the world because you will definitely receive that. Believe in karma because it really exists. The goods that you do in this world, you are paid for it in some event down the line. And it may not come back to you the same way. It may come back to you in another form, like a higher salary job or even opportunities. Like you may be working on a business and you see that you're starting to have a flood of clients and your business is just booming and growing because you have done such good in this world. So always think positive. And you'll also notice too, as the more experience that you had over time with whatever field that you are in and your skill set, you'll have to do less of that whole negotiation. And right off the bat, you're probably going to be getting at least what you want or around it. So always keep that in mind. Just keep working towards yourself and your skill set and believe in yourself. I must say though, I had some companies reach out to me with some lowball offers. They were offering me less than what I was making at my current place at that time before I made the transition to where I'm at now. I was not going to settle for that. The previous company I was at, they were paying pretty well. And I knew where I was at and I knew pretty much what I was worth because I knew what I brought to the table. I believed in myself and I knew that I was had a unique skill set that many people didn't have. Pretty much for me in my field, I'm a designer, but I also know development. I know how to code and I know how to communicate with developers whenever I needed to. So certain things that they were building, I just knew how to design it in a certain way to make their lives, I can't say super easy, but in a way that's justifiable. And these communication, whenever they were faced with roadblocks, I show them ways that they can approach this to pretty much come out of that roadblock. And these are knowledge that I gained over time because I was in both fields pretty much, but my main focus was on to design. It's just that additional skill set that I had made companies save money, because if you design something that is so out of this world, costs so much to build, you're going to end up costing the company a lot of money. but I factor all these things in when I am designing. So essentially I was 2 person in one. You're going to value me exactly where I'm at because I worked hard to get here, and make sure you express that. You express that always. Don't be rude about it now. Just express that in your value. Just say, this is where I'm at. Unfortunately, you know, that's what I'm looking for. And really stick to that. And be realistic too. Don't be, let's say your field is paying, let's say around 120 to 150. And thinking you're gonna make $500,000. No, don't be unrealistic now. Be realistic with what the ranges are and be somewhere close to it. Like if you know your field is like 120 and you're asking for like 160, 170, that's pretty much realistic. You know, it's not impossible. That's just 40, 50 grand above where the middle people is, the regular people is, and you're not regular, you are unique. So take that into consideration when you're factoring how much you should actually be worth. If you're just getting out of college, it could be a little bit tough because you had no history, you had no starting point. You may have worked some off jobs, not really jobs within the field that you are into. Like for me, I knew that my middle range was around like 60 grand. It's important that you ask for what you think you are worth. For me, I was above that, so I asked for a little bit more than that 60, that average one that most people were getting, because I already had that knowledge of both designing and development that many people didn't have. So right off the bat, I wanted more than what I knew what the average was. If you already had working experience and you pretty much have a starting point, it is a little bit easier. So let's say you're at 120K and or your last employment, let's say you're not working right now and your last employment was at 120K. I generally say 20% is a good gap because you don't want to leave a place where you were dealing with some BS to go to another place where you're still going to be dealing with some BS in a different way. Like there's always going to be an imperfection about each company that you are at. You're never going to have a perfect company that you work for where everything is just going to be golden sweet. You're always going to have a little bit of a bottleneck here and there with somebody. And it might not be right away, it might be over time. That's why you should never settle for one imperfect company to make the same at another imperfect company, because you don't know, you haven't been there long enough. The interview might go all sweet, but down the line, you're going to eventually find out what the imperfections are for that company. So always go for that 20% gap. So at 120, that would actually be a 24,000. So that should take you up to about 144,000. And again, that's a range. You could settle for like 140, 150. It doesn't really matter. I'm just suggesting if you think you're at your higher value, of course you're gonna shoot for more. If you think that you are a little less or even something that comes around the line, it's completely fine. Unless you absolutely just hate this job where you're at and you just have to run and leave, then of course you're going to end up leaving. But honestly, from my experience, if there's something you hate about a job, the next one will have something that you don't like either. It may not be right away. It may be over time. Just always keep that in the back of your head. But if it's completely horrible, it's a nightmare, and you just have to leave, then always take something. And it should be at least of what you're getting. Do not ever work backwards and take less. That is just a no unacceptable thing to do. Unless your industry is completely running out of business and you have to switch industries, then I can understand how that can play into you're making a little bit less. Now, if you're switching over and it's actually not a salary position, let's say it's a W-2, same thing. Take that 20% rule factor that I've given you, right? So you're expecting a 144,000 salary. Now on a W-2 basis, use that same math of the 0.00065 to determine the hourly rate. So that's actually about $92 an hour. And you can settle for around that range. It could be 85, it could even be more than that, it could be 95. If you think you're deserving more, if you think you're above a certain level, then go shoot for it. If you think you're a little less, I wouldn't suggest that. I really think you should be shooting up for the stars at all time, always. You should definitely try to shoot for more and more and push the envelope as much as you can. Continue to build on your skill set and your craft. To sum this up, do not ever take anything less than what you think you're worth. Do not ever let anyone try to devalue you or offer you less than the value that you know that you're worth, unless it's on a realistic number. Just keep it at a realistic range. And if they're doing that, trying to battle out with you, just keep it moving. Keep it moving, do not work backwards. You wanna keep working forward towards getting the next goal. We wanna keep elevating ourselves as much as we can, because industries continue to grow and make more money every single year. And the right job is going to come to you. You just have to be patient with it at the right amount that you know that you're worth. The chemistry is going to be great with the people that you want, and you will probably have to do very little or even no negotiations. You're probably going to get that number that you want right off the bat. You just have to wait for the right one. Be patient with the process. Trust yourself and always believe in yourself. The energy should always just feel organic and natural, no matter where you have been interviewing, where you're supposed to start. Just keep that in mind. Always shoot up for as high as you can, because you may miss the high target, but you're always gonna end up higher than where you are. So please subscribe if you haven't done so already. Drop a comment if you can. Let me know your thoughts, and let me know the experiences that you have endured in terms of doing salary negotiations. I'd love to hear all about it. Just let me know in the comments or shoot me a message throughout my social media. And stay tuned, because I have a lot more for you guys, and I'm looking forward to hearing and sharing more experiences with you as well. Peace.